Hey there, this is Thimbleweed Bark. It's kind of like an old school LucasArts game, but not old because it just came out. And it looks pretty good, so I figure might as well try it out.
I fly halfway around the world and an odd note is waiting for me in my hotel room. It says to come to the bridge down by the river. This looks like the place. I could really go for some Wiener Schnitzel after the long walk out here.
Dude, same. Open. Oh man, old school. Alright, talk to you. Wait, no, look at him. Are you a victim of the inferior American social support system?
Are you a victim of the inferior American social support system?
I need some whiskey.
Fucking same, dog. Dude, you should sober up, though.
Sober up, sir?
I'm glad Chuck is dead.
Oh, that voice acting line was, not there. That's okay. You should wake up, though.
Wake up, sir.
Wake up, sir.
Wake up, sir.
One more time.
Wake up, sir.
Okay.
I have to go. Sleep well.
Good night, man. What is this? Alright. Boris, I'm glad you decided this is the right solution to our problem. There are eyes everywhere, so follow these steps precisely. For your own protection, leave your ID in your hotel room. I guess I did that. Go to the river down by the Trestle Trail Bridge. Okay. Turn off the light above the Trestle Trail sign so I know you've arrived. Okay, because that was the red light. And meet me at the large entrance to the underground sewers. Make sure you are not followed. Interesting. And my wallet?
It is my wallet, and it has 252 American dollars in it.
That's a lot of dollars.
It is the key card for my room.
You have a bear.
It is a pillow bear prototype. Turn the bear inside out, and you get a pillow.
Holy
shit!
Very
top secret.
That's crazy. All right, buddy. Ooh. You go pretty fast, man. You want to look at this? Here.
Trestle Trail to Thimbleweed Park, 1.7 miles.
Yep. You might use kilometers where you're from, but don't worry, dog.
I wonder how I can turn off the light to let them know I'm here. Must be something around here that can help.
Maybe the rock? Would you like to pick it? Wait, oh, pick up. I like the little hints. Okay.
I wonder if I can use this rock to put out the light.
Do you mean this light? I mean, I could use it if you want me to. Alright, use rock on light. You're welcome.
There! I've completed step 3 of the note. Now for step 4.
Good for me. I'm also not really experienced with point-and-click adventure games, but this seemed like it'd be up my alley, so I said screw it. I'm going very fast. Ooh. Whoa! Oh, okay. I just wanted wiener schnitzel. None of us were prepared for what we'd find that night, or how much it would change us all. Oh, shit. Holy shit, Mulder and Scully.
So tell me again why you're here.
I was assigned to the case by the Home Office in Albuquerque.
There is no Home Office in Albuquerque.
It's neat to know.
Look, I like working a case alone. I especially don't need some junior agent messing up my investigation. Especially some junior agent that thinks I don't know there isn't a Home Office in Albuquerque. So stay out of my way. Take a lot of notes. Sit back and learn. And I'll wrap up this case and we can both get the hell out of here.
Your reputation certainly precedes you, Agent Ray.
I'll take that as a compliment, Agent Reyes.
It's how it was intended.
I'm sure it was. Let's photograph the victim and head into town to talk to the local sheriff. The body is starting to pixelate.
Body starting to pixelate.
This is going to be a long night.
Yes, it is. All right, so use camera on body.
There's no film in the camera.
Oh, shit. Do we have film? Fuck, do you have film?
I think we'd better take a photo of that body before it pixelates any further.
You're right.
Appears to be a male, approximately 40 years old. Looks like he's been in the water for 24 hours. You can tell by the pixelation around the nose and neck. Let's see here. There's no wallet in his pockets. But I found a card, possibly a key card from a hotel.
But we had like 256 American dollars. Also, there's a bottle. Pick it up.
I think we'd better take a photo of that body before it pixelates any further.
I would like to, but I don't have any camera footage. Film, yes.
It's an empty whiskey bottle. Definitely not the murder weapon. Wrong sized body hole.
You're right. Do you by chance have any film?
Looks fine to me.
You wanna... Can I talk to you? I cannot talk to myself, I guess. Okay, pick up the body.
That's the coroner's job.
You're right, I'm sorry. Notebook? Appears to be a male. Looks like he's been in the water for 24 hours, nothing in his pockets. So they took his wallet and the pillow bear. Maybe it was all, like, because it was a prototype. So maybe they killed him to steal it and then sell it for another thing. It's a genius idea and no one would suspect it. Okay, where? Well, cell phone. Use it. Click on the flashing head icon to switch characters. Oh. Huh. Okay. Click it. Click. There we go. Hey. Do you have film that I didn't notice? You do have film. I am but a fool. Can I give this to you?
It's a sample package of Polaroid film.
You're right.
It only contains one photo.
Give this to you.
Sure. I'll carry your crap.
I like the spunk. Alrighty. And then use this on the... Alright. And then use this on
you. I think we'd better take a photo of that body before it pixelates any further.
Smile.
I did it.
Now we can head into town and find the local sheriff.
Hang on one second. On the light.
There's no film in the camera.
We only had enough for one picture? Man, the 80s were scary. Or expensive. I'm not really sure. Alright.
We should go find the sheriff.
You're right, Reyes. Right click to execute the highlighted verb. Oh. Okay. Double click to quick. Oh my god. That's crazy. Hold down left click to get your character to follow the cursor. Whoa. Dips. That's cool.
It's a trail down to the railroad trestle.
Tuna can.
Is an empty can of Crockford's tuna heads, the good parts.
Pick it up. Sick. All right, well, we got tuna.
I don't see anything up ahead. I think the town must be in the other direction.
You're right. Can I not switch characters? Whoa! He stays? That's so weird! Huh. So I can have them in different areas. All right, you watch the road, man. Hitchhike for us. I gotta go to town. Hold on. Wait, oh, there's a... okay. Good luck with that. There was a thing here. An Atari cartridge.
Behind jaggy lines from Mucus Phlegm Games? I don't get it. Who'd ever let a game be named that?
A reference would. I don't think I want an Atari game, though. No offense. You?
It's a circus flyer with a crazy-looking clown on it. Pretty good makeup, though.
Russ. Yo, oh.
Signals are very strong tonight.
Why are you dressed like a giant pigeon?
Why are you dressed like a giant pigeon?
We're the Pigeon Brothers Plumbing. I'm Beth. That's my sister Emily.
Hi there!
But remember, signals are very strong tonight.
Why are you brothers if that...
Why brothers if you're sisters?
Dad was expecting to have sons, and he was too cheap to have the van repainted. So we're just rolling with it till he's dead.
Oh, soon.
Shut up, Emily. Signals are very strong tonight.
Okay, I'll bite.
What signals?
The signals. Signals are very strong tonight.
Okay.
Yes, you already said that. But what signals?
I'm just screwing with you. Dark night. Deserted road. Me in a giant pigeon costume? It was too good to pass up. But the signals are strong tonight.
Very strong.
Wow. This is really odd. Should I save my game?
This is really odd. Should I save my game?
I wouldn't worry about it. The game was expertly designed to have no dead ends or death, yet still be scary and have a sense of tension. You can feel safe exploring whatever you want. But I'd watch out for the signals. They can be very strong and disrupt the power grid.
I don't know what a fourth wall is anymore.
But playing classic adventure games has taught me to save often.
That was true, up until Monkey Island. At least with LucasArts-style adventures. Then the designers realized that death and dead ends weren't making the game more enjoyable. It was actually making it less fun.
You're fucking right!
That seems like a sensible approach to adventure game design.
It is. It just takes a little longer and requires more thought and planning. But it really pays off in the end.
You guys, or I'm sorry, lady brothers, are right. Also, you kind of ran me over almost.
You almost ran over a federal agent. That's a felony.
Sorry about that. Like I said, the signals are very strong tonight.
They're so strong!
Do you know anything about the body by the bridge?
Why is it whenever a dead body is found, suspicion always falls to the person dressed as a giant bird?
Hey, if the beak fits.
We don't know anything about a dead body, but the signals are strong tonight.
Very strong.
Uh-huh.
I think I've had enough of you. I need to find the sheriff and solve a murder.
Nice talking to you, too. Beep!
Woo!
Squeak!
Heek!
Beep!
Squeak!
Boop!
Was.
Squeak!
Beep!
I gotta go.
Whack! Was. Eek!
No need. The perps are outside.
I gotta go.
Boop!
Oh god, littering.
From a six-pack, you're supposed to cut them up before tossing them.
You're right.
It saves wildlife.
It turtles, man. They're gonna kill somebody. That's a cemetery. I don't need to go there, I gotta go to the sheriff. Hold on a second. Can I use this?
The cell phone has no reception.
Of course it doesn't.
Wait for me.
No. All right. Well, there's a boarded up doorway.
It's dark, but I can see there's nothing in there.
Just sadness. Willie's.
Willie's Watch and Violin Repair Shop. Thimbleweed County's most exclusive watch and violin repair. We repair watches and violins for the rich or famous.
That's a very specific trait. Prestige realtors. Oh, ride the bust. Oh, hi.
Howdy, I'm the Thimbleweed Park Sheriff. I don't remember calling the Federinos. That's what you are, feds. Hard to miss the government issue suits.
damn straight, son.
Damn straight, we're the feds.
Whoa, hold your horse-a-rinos. No need to get snippy. Looks like you heard about our little murder-rino out by the bridge, huh?
There is nothing little about murder, sir.
Ignore him. He's new.
No sense in wasting everyone's time, Reno. This cutscene is starting to get long, and it's only gonna get longer. Let's find the coroner and get you on your way. Wrestling starts at 8.
I hope he's talking about on TV.
This fourth wall.
The coroner is waiting for you in his office. Come see me when you're done. I apologize, Areno, for all the lights being off. We don't stay open as long as you city slickerinos do at night.
Even for a murder?
Especially for murder.
That makes no sense.
Are we authorized to shoot people Arenos?
What if they were in Reno? Would it be called Reno Areno? That just sounds like a pasta. I want to drink it. Yes. Oh, a lap lap sip sip go. Oh shit, yeah. Oh god, I'm so thirsty. Oh, it's like ASMR. Holy shit, is this a porn? Damn. Hey, coroner, I don't gotta go there yet. All right, let's go to the door. Yeah, let's do that. Yo, what up? Sheriff. Ooh, Arrestatron 3000.
It looks like a big computer.
I want it. Sheriff, wait, I thought you came in here. Was I not paying attention properly? Wrestling starts at 8.
It doesn't have any buttons.
Shoot.
Must be for incoming calls only.
Coroner, maybe I definitely didn't think right. I'm sorry. Let's try that again. Hey.
Howdy ho, I'm the Thimbleweed Park Coroner. Welcome to the future, who? Oh, these are the latest in crime-fighting computers made by Pillowtronics, Inc. This is all probably pretty advanced, even for the Fedahoos.
Oh, do enlighten us.
Ooh, I love your sarcastic humor, Who, Agent Ray.
It's not humor.
There you go again.
We're interested in any help your computers can give us. They look marvelous.
Yes, happy to explain. So happy to explain, Who. Yeah, you might want to take notes.
Already on it.
All right. Well, aren't you the Sheriff Areno?
Aren't you the Sheriff Areno?
Oh my, no. No. Who? Well, people say there is some resemblance around the eyes, but we're as different as peas of who's in a pot of who. Plus, the Sheriff has that annoying Areno he adds to everything. You'll never hear me doing that, who?
Sure. Whatever.
You're right. Tell us about the Facetron 3000.
Oh, tell us about the Facetron 3000.
The Facetron 3000. Or, as I like to call it...
Let me guess. The face of Reno?
No, that's what the sheriff calls it. You city folka who crack me up. Just insert two pictures of an individual and it will verify a positive match.
Two pictures? Okay.
Tell us about the Fingertron 3000.
Right, Areno. The Fingertron 3000. Insert a fingerprint registry of known criminals and a fingerprint from the murder weapon on fingerprint tape, and it will do a match-a-hoo.
You said Areno. You broke character.
Tell us about the Bloodtron 3000.
This is the Bloodtron 3000. Put two bloody objects in, and it will match the blood type, printing out a report-a-hoo.
Huh. Didn't this?
Did you use these computers to investigate the Pillow factory fire?
Oh, sure did. Four computers positively showed the fire was caused by the factory guard. No doubt a who about it.
That's terrible.
Could the computers have been wrong about the fire?
Not these computers. Oh, the state-of-the-art a who computers made by Pillowtronics. Absolutely infallible.
Of course they are.
Isn't there a conflict of interest with Pillowtronics and the fire?
Whoa, now! Pillowtronics and its founder, Chuck, are above reproach. Chuck built this town and was a computer and pillow genius. Are the feds looking into this case? It was solved 20 years ago.
No, he's just curious. He's a pillow factory fire buff. He's got a CompuServe chat room and everything.
That is so fucking funny.
Fascinating stuff. I think we've heard enough. This is all very impressive, sir. This should cut hours of our investigation.
Go see the sheriff in his office for a full explanation of the amazing Arrestron 3000. I have some paperwork to do, who? Oh, yeah, almost forgot. These Tron machines are fully voice-activated, so if you need any information, just talk to them. It's like we're living in the futuristic year of 2017!
Wow!
I hate this town.
Let's investigate these Tron machines, then go see the sheriff and get out of here.
You're right. Yo, face Tron. Here.
It's a good photo of the body. I like how the state-of-the-art camera can alter the angle of the shot.
That is so impressive. You're welcome. I want to talk to it. What's 2 plus 2?
4.
That's good.
32,921,056.
Very good. What's the square root of 67?
8.18535272.
What's the last digit of pi?
Calculate.
I fucked up.
Calculate. 5. No, wait. 7.
That's good.
The primary function of the Phasetron 3000 trademark is to analyze a photograph of a dead body and compare it with an official photographic ID to provide a positive identification of the victim.
Thank you. What kind of official identification? I need that still.
The Phasetron 3000 trademark requires official government identification that contains a photograph of the victim.
So, you're thinking like a driver's license?
Sure. Whatever.
Thanks, man. Alright, I'm gonna go.
Subroutine exit.
Yo, later, dog. What a cool guy, what a cool guy. Skeletons.
It's a medical skeleton. Please return to Dr. Fred.
I'm gonna talk to him. Damn.
It's a very dark and smelly flight of stairs leading up to the door.
Disgusting. All right, Sheriff, who is also not the coroner, go. Hey, man.
Hello again, Agent Arenos. Hopefully, the coroner fills you in on our state-of-the-art Areno computers.
Yep. You're also the coroner, though. The coroner said yes.
The coroner said something about the arrestron?
Yes, the arrestron 3000. The last step in a fully computerized Areno arrest. The final link in the chain of a guaranteed conviction Areno. Every detail Areno analyzed and verified by computer.
Moving on.
Right, sorry Areno, I get carried away sometimes. This is the big bad boy Areno you've been hearing about. The Arrestron 3000. Just feed three reports from other Tron machines into this and it issues a 100% Areno valid arrest warrant. Yeah, these machines are the reason we need only one law enforcement officer Areno. Chuck said that computers will soon put us all out of work, allowing for a full life of luxury.
Who is that?
Who is this Chuck we keep hearing about?
Sadly, Chuck passed away a few days ago. There was a big service out at the cemetery, Areno. Oh, the entire town showed up, which isn't surprising for the hero of Thimbleweed County. We'll talk more about Chuck later. I need to run Areno and check on a disturbance call out at the old circus. Probably that stupid clown Areno again.
Damn clowns.
Looks like we need to go talk to the rest of the weirdos that live in this town.
We should split up. It will be faster.
You cooling your heels in the local diner would also make things go faster.
If we follow agency questioning protocols, this shouldn't take long.
Just don't mess anything up. I want to get out of here as fast as possible.
Agreed.
Same. I mean, truth be told, it's not too bad of a town, but I understand if you want to get home and, I don't know, watch TV. What's up, Pigeon Brothers? I gotta go. Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? Can we talk?
No time to talk. We have to fix this slight leak.
Why? Yeah?
What caused the leak?
Well, the Hydrotron's tube is obviously burned out. We could use a new one. A WC-67? Yeah, we're out of that size.
Must have been the signals.
Yes, the signals.
Damn the signals. Can I steal this wrench? I probably shouldn't, but I kind of want to. I guess it would pick up. That's the button I'm looking for. Don't look.
Don't touch our Wrenchtron 3000. Only someone like me with the proper training can handle it.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. I'm gonna go now. I meant to do it. I'm lying to you. Huh. Safety first savings. Oh, no, I'm good. Flowers. Ooh, S&D Diner. Yo, what up, Sandy?
Welcome to the S&D Diner. Hey, just so you know, that article in the Thimbleweed Nickel about botulism was a smear job. So, what can I do for you, honey?
Well, what's up with the sheriff?
What's up with the sheriff? He's kind of weird Areno.
Yeah, he's kind of a nut job, but nothing compared to the coroner. This whole town has gotten downright weird in the last few years. Cuckooville.
Cuckoo-ca-choo.
The coroner and the sheriff are the same person.
Well, there might be some resemblance around the eyes, but that's about it. The sheriff does this annoying Areno thing, and the coroner does an annoying a who. It pretty much proves they're not the same person.
You're fucking right.
How does speech prove they are not the same person?
You're asking a lot of questions that probably shouldn't be asked.
I'm a federal agent. That's my job.
I've said too much already.
I'm so sorry. Do you know anything about a body?
I'm a federal agent. Know anything about the dead body?
Not too much, just scuttlebutt from the morning breakfast crowd. And I don't want to get into trouble, especially with a crazy person like him.
You're not talking about me, are you?
Shut up, Dave.
Fucking Dave.
Don't screw with the feds. Tell us what you know.
Okay, honey. But you didn't hear this from me. I'd look into that crazy clown that lives out at the old circus. He's been out there since the circus closed down years ago. Never takes his makeup off. He's got serial killer written all over him. It all happened about 9 or 10 years ago.
Flashback.
Ransom the Jerk was the featured act at Stupendous Brothers Circus. He was about ready to go on stage and meet his well-earned doom.
Big night tonight. Full house after my raunchiest Tonight Show appearance. I really got Johnny good, that little jackwad. It's his own fault for not being able to take a joke. I better get ready to go on stage and insult the crap out of these Thimbleweed idiots. I just need to fix my hair, put on my makeup and clown nose, and find my joke book.
You are so right. Walk to shiny trophies, look at them.
Meanest clown of 1977 and 1978. Ransom the clown.
You are so talented.
My circus poster, featuring the amazing Ransom the Clown. That's me, face.
That is you, beep face.
It came off the wall.
You're damn right. Can you open it? Oh, open it. Money.
That's a load of moolah.
That is. Go ahead and pick that up, buddy. You are loaded.
It's exactly $1,000 in unmarked bills.
Sick. Go ahead and close that. All right, nice. All right, note.
It's an IOU. I, Carney Joe, loan Ransom the clown $1,000 and will hold his joke book hostage until I gets paid.
Damn, dog. I respect that. You want to microwave your nose? No, you don't. Okay, fridge? You have nothing in your fridge. Go ahead and close that. Faucet.
My housekeeper does a pretty good job of keeping this place clean.
You have such a way with words. Where's your makeup? There's a bed.
It's a prototype Ransom the Clown doll. It's a perfect likeness of me. Well, maybe the nose is a bit too big.
I think he's cute.
Very cozy. My maid changed the sheets today.
What a nice lady.
I'm not ready for my pants. My hair is all frizzy and I'm not wearing my special Ransom clown makeup or nose. I better stick my nose on.
Okay, at least put your nose on. We
it's
can
my
do
clown
that.
Nose, head.
I'm sorry, okay? Jeez. Freaking just use your nose. There you
Ouch.
Go.
That's tight. Glad I only have to wear it for a couple of hours.
Yep. All right, how about this door at least? Shit.
Ransom, I'm glad I caught you before you went on stage.
Autographs are $100.
Ransom, I'm your business manager and lawyer. I don't want your autograph.
Okay, 50 then.
I just wanted to let you know that your mistress is waiting at your house in Aspen, and your private jet is being fueled and ready to whisk you there when the show is over. Also, we have a deal worth millions to license a line of toddler Ransom the Clown talking insult dolls.
Did you get the liability clause waived?
Correct. They will assume all liability when the kids grow up to be beepholes.
Good. Toddlers start out as It's not my fault they end up that way. Okay, fine. $25.
I should have been a dentist.
You.
He's such a nice guy. All right, we gotta go get our makeup done. I'm going to assume we gotta get our makeup done somewhere else. Maybe over here.
No one out there. They must be all waiting for my show.
You're right. You're freaking right. Look at this list. Get my beeping joke book back. Oh, you have so many things to do. Okay. Well, if that's the case, we can't go this way? Or can't? Oh, we can. Yo, dog!
Well, you.
Fucking mimes. Backstage entrance, I'm probably gonna need that. Ooh, that's a nice clown-o. Hey man. Fuck, I don't think I gotta go this way. I wanna play.
I guaranteed to hit something.
I wanna play.
You got my money, clowny?
That's Ransom the Clown, asswipe.
Okay, you got my money, Ransom the asswipe clown? 1,000 clams or you're not getting your joke book back. Eh, serves you right for playing the duckies.
You are so right. How's the old ball and chain and kids?
So, how's the old ball and chain and kids, huh?
My wife's doing fine, no thanks to you. And so are the 8 kids. But they still cries themselves to sleep every night after that scare you gave them.
That's so bad.
How many kids do you say you have?
I have 8 kids, why?
Oh, nothing.
I was just curious.
I need my joke book. The crowd's waiting for me.
I told you before, you ain't getting it till I get the $1,000 you owe me for the duckies. Plus, $138 in interest.
Where the f*** am I gonna get that kind of dough? I have a show to do.
Not my problem. I don't know, Ransom the Asswipe Clown. Maybe it's time to rob the jar.
The jar?
I have your money. $1,000.
Oh, so you decided to pay up.
Yeah, here's your money. Now where's my junk buck?
Wait, are you messing with me? That's only $1,000 and you owe me $1,138, including the interest.
Thought you'd settle for less. Beggars can't be choosers.
Oh, yeah? Well, I choose to hang on to your joke book till I gets the full $1,138. Now, beggar off.
Fine.
Try your skill.
No, fuck you. God, what a dick. That's a bear. All right. Well, if that's the case, popcorn.
It's fresh out of that crappy popcorn. Must be a huge crowd in the Big Top.
It has to be. All right, let's try the back entrance. There might be some kind of thing. Okay. Swear jar. That's probably loaded, right?
It's my Ransom the Clown swear jar with $138 in it. My contract states that I'm the only one who's allowed to swear. Anyone else caught swearing has to pay up.
Damn. Go ahead and take it. Wait, don't pick it up.
I'll just take the big bucks.
Is it enough?
It's exactly $1,138 in unmarked bills.
Good. Yo, how about doing your makeup though, huh? You can do that, right?
This goop keeps my clown fro erect. Can't have a limp clown fro or anything else.
That'd be horrible.
Now there's the face I love.
God, you look so good. Goop it up.
Ooh, my clown fro looks great now.
Do you want the hat?
I don't wear hats.
I was just curious. I didn't think you did either. All right, well, we have... Oh, a cannon? Nah, don't worry about cannons. Cannons are for chumps. All right, we got the money. We'll go get our joke book. We're going to tell some sweet jokes. Hey, man.
Shoot the birdie!
It's exactly $1,138 in unmarked bills.
Give you here.
Step right... Oh, so you decided to pay up.
Yeah, well, not much choice. Now, where's my joke book?
Yeah, the jokes all suck. So how'd you get to be so famous with jokes like these?
Yeah? What do you know about being funny?
About as much as you do, which is nothing. Now scram, Clowny. You're scaring the customers.
There are no customers,
come
sir.
Come on over!
It's my joke book. No spoilers here. You have to wait for my show for the jokes.
I'm sorry. All right, so go on stage and insult the fuck out. I'm sorry. The beep out of the idiots. Guess my life is amazing and beep you for being jealous. I'm sorry. I don't mean to be jealous. It's just you're a clowno, and it's kind of a thing. Cannon.
I'm not a wannabe pirate. You'll never get me to climb into one of those.
Same.
Hello, faces. I'm Ransom the Insult Clown. I hope no one gets their feelings hurt easily, and if you do, it's your own fault for not being able to take a joke.
You know, there are a lot of references here. I don't know a whole lot of them, but I know there are. I think this is Maniac Mansion. That's the Day of the Tentacle. I think that's a guy. There's probably more, but I know there's references, and I appreciate the fact that they're there. Let's see here. I gotta insult them pretty good. You guys are obsessed with this Chuck guy.
You guys are obsessed with this Chuck guy. Seriously, I haven't seen brainwashing like this since the Manson family. Blink twice if you want me to get help.
Wow. Okay. What's the deal with them? I'm being Seinfeld.
What's the deal with all these Tron machines? That's some great priorities you got there. Yeah, you can't cure cancer or help the blind see, but at least you don't have to wipe your own asses thanks to the Toiletron 3000!
Trademark. Ooh. Wow, don't insult the dude in the wheelchair, man, what the fuck? Mustache. He can deal with that one.
Hey, you, dude with the stupid mustache. You think you look like Magnum P.I.? A 70s porn star called. He wants his mustache back.
He's so sad. Oh, God. Dude. This is terrible.
Hey, you, ugly old lady with the hairy mole. Or is it your parasitic twin? Whatever it is, I hope you bought a separate ticket. Because if it's big enough to ride the roller coaster by itself, it's not freeloading in my audience.
You will be forever sorry for what you've just said. I curse you to never be able to remove your makeup and to roam these circus grounds until the end of time.
He went on for another 2 hours, insulting everyone he could. Some people laughed because they thought it was funny, but most laughed because they were uncomfortable, and laughing is the best way to hide from the embarrassment of others. But after the show, in his dressing room, there wasn't going to be any laughter.
Ha! I killed tonight! One of my best shows ever! I hope that ugly old lady with a curse breaks a hip on the way home. Now to get this makeup off, hop on my private jet, and go see my mistress Cindy in Aspen. Yeah. What the f***? This makeup isn't coming off! The f***? You, old lady! You up the you come on!
As much as he tried, his makeup wouldn't come off. That old lady wasn't just any old lady. She was Madame Morena, mistress of the dark arts. When she curses you, it's not an empty threat. Something Ransom was just now finding out.
This makeup of that old my lady!
Ransom, I've got some bad news.
What do you want, you bald, greedy little... Can't you see I'm having a problem? Grab a tissue and some rubbing alcohol and help me, you...
Your private jet crashed while trying to land. Your wife found out about your mistress, and she's taking everything you own except the house in Aspen. There was a fire in Aspen, and your house burned to the ground. The toy and doll licensing deal is dead, and they're suing you for breach. And one more thing. I quit.
What?
And go beep yourself.
That was a whole lot to take in at once.
And that's why Ransom the Clown is such a creep. And you should go arrest him for murder.
That's an interesting story. We'll go check up on him.
We will. But first, hot dogs. Can I have one?
I'll have one of these hot dogs.
Good choice, honey. We're trying to move him out. Let me get that for you. Eat up, hon, while it's still hot.
Yeah, you... Yeah?
Oh, my. That is the worst hot dog I've ever eaten. Gotta go.
But it was... Oh, no.
I feel better now.
Are you sure you don't want another one? I was gonna get another one. Let's get another one. That's a good idea. Hey, I'm here for the second.
No way am I gonna eat another one of those.
Frick. Alright, well, I gotta go see about a clown. Have a good day. Great people, truly. Where is the circus?
The street ends just ahead. I see flashing lights.
It might be here.
Hello, Reno. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, it is quite annoying. No, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, they will be taken care of. Yes, sir. Permanently. Oh, yes, sir. Violently. No, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, wrestling was quite good tonight. Goodbye, sir.
There's a conspiracy. I should have expected this. I don't know why I didn't.
Welcome to Quickie Pal. Can I help you find anything?
Hey dude, I'm ready for some quicks.
Hi there, I'm Quickie Pal Leonard. How can I help you?
I'm Special Agent Ray.
I'm not Holden, if that's what you're thinking.
I actually was. Also, you have a rat. You mentioned that? No. Also, yeah, you have flickering lights too.
These flickering lights are going to drive me insane.
Yeah, it's a trip, isn't it? Oh, they're even better if you get a little toked up and, I mean, yes, officer, I'll get those fixed right away.
As you should. What's your deal, dude?
So, what's your deal, Leonard?
Dude, how do you know my name? Are you, like, telepathic or something?
No, you just told me your name, and it's also on your name tag.
Do you like it here?
Do you like your job here at the Quickie Pal?
Heck yeah! I got a freaking sweet deal here, with free coffee and minimum wage. Plus, I don't get many customers on the late shift, so I get plenty of time to think.
That's so cool!
You said you get a lot of time to think.
I'm like an abstract thinker, way ahead of the curve, man. My mom says I should be more like my cousin Bernard, who got a scholarship to MIT. But why be like that dweeb when I could be like Chuck Edmund?
He's dead, though.
Tell me about Chuck.
He's my freaking hero, man. Dude never went to college, just started building his machines when he was a kid. That guy made this town rich just by doing what he loved.
What a great guy.
You seem to really admire Chuck.
That's why I dropped out of high school. I don't want to live my life for the man like some peon in a polyester cage. No offense.
Offense taken.
You should at least get a GED, man. I mean, come on.
What do you think about the state of the town?
Just ignore the losers who say this town is over. I mean, not even. We got everything a person could ever need here in the Quickie Pal, for one.
You're right.
Do you know anything about the body by the river?
No, but I heard the sheriff nearly ralphed when he saw it. The only bods I've seen lately are the righteous babes at the top shelf of the magazine rack.
I'm not surprised the only women you see naked are in magazines.
Whoa, that was cold.
Have you seen anyone acting suspiciously around town?
Actually, now you mention it, I did see something suspicious a couple of nights ago. I was on the late shift getting ready to close up and grab some za when Willie the town bum walks in. Was totally whack when I think about it.
But why?
Why did Willie seem suspicious to you?
Well, normally we have to toss him out because the dude smells grody and he never has any money. But for the first time in forever, bro pulls out this wallet and flashes a fat stack of dead presidents. I thought it was kind of bitchin' when he bought out the liquor cabinet.
Oh, that was the guy that was drinking at the very beginning and he took the wallet. Gotcha.
Could the wallet you saw have belonged to Willie?
Oh, no way! That wallet was his! I figured he got lucky and found it. Whoa. But come to think of it, I'm pretty sure the wallet had some weird red stains on it. At the time, I thought it was the cherry mouthwash he drinks, but it could have been blood.
No.
I need you to hand over the security tape.
Oh, no can do, broski. We only have one Betamax tape here at the Quickie Pal, and the boss man would freak if I gave it away. If I lose it, my ass is grass.
But why?
Why do you have a Betamax player?
We have one sweet, cutting-edge Betamax player here. We don't want to be stuck with a piece of obsolete technology when VHS bites the big one. Gotta invest in the superior tech, dude.
I'm so sorry.
I'm going to look around your store.
You are going to regret things, but that, you know what? You do you, boo.
It's called Levo's Bear Repellent. When you have this, you don't need to bear arms.
Let me know if I can help you find anything.
Can I take this?
Take it. It was a sample from a traveling animal repellent salesman. But I doubt if it actually works. I wouldn't want to find out.
Yeah, you're right. Would you like tuna?
He doesn't want it.
Fuck. Who'd have thought? Can I just drop it? Like, what exactly do I do if I want to get rid of things? I never really thought about this. Because I kind of have a lot. Is there a limit? Probably not, right?
Don't forget to smile at the camera. My boss likes happy people.
I want to look at it.
It's a video camera.
Can I spray it? Probably shouldn't, but I'm gonna try.
Let me know if I can help.
Ugh, smells awful.
Oh, I wanted to use this.
Ugh,
oh.
Smells awful.
I kind of wanted to just spray the camera for no reason.
I'm here to serve.
Man-eating plant.
It looks hungry. I don't have an extra finger, though.
It's very grumpy. I'm gonna go. Have a good one, Leonard. Okay. So, how about the clown place? AKA the circus. You understand. Assuming it's over here. I see it. In eyesight.
Whoa there, little Agent Areno.
Hi.
You can't just go bumbling around the county without a map. It's too easy to get lost. There is a killerino on the loose.
You're right. I'm a federal agent, though.
I am a federal agent. I can take care of myself.
And a darn fine agent, I'm sure of. But we have laws around here, and everyone is required to have an official map.
You know, you're right. But donuts.
Aren't there some donuts that need eating?
Well, you got me there. Ooh, those donuts aren't gonna eat themselves. But we have laws around here, and everyone is required to have an official map.
Fine.
Yeah, you're right. I'll head back to town and find a map.
Ooh, donuts do sound good.
Leonard!
Can I help you find anything?
Yo, dude, I need a map.
There aren't any maps left.
Sorry, little dudette. The sheriff came by a bit ago and nabbed all the maps. Didn't even pay for them. Something about immature dominion or something like that.
Are you kidding me? Sheriff?
Like I said before, you can't just go bumbling around the county without a map.
But you took a... God damn it.
Yeah, you're right. I'll head back to town and find a map.
Ooh, donuts do sound good.
All right, what about B Street? I could do B Street, right? This is new. There's a dumpster.
Filled to the brim with smelly trash.
Gross. Puppy sale. Dope. Cakes. Hello, I'm here for cakes.
Hey there. Let's go over to the counter where we can talk. Alrighty now.
I can't quite put my finger on it, but this place stinks of false advertising.
Sorry about that, hon. This used to be Ricky's Cakes, but now we sell vacuum tubes.
That's a lot of vacuum tubes.
What an exciting life you lead. Anyway, I'm Special Agent Ray. I have some questions for you.
Oh, pleased to meet you. I'm Ricky Lee, and I'm the proprietor of this little store. What can I do for you, hon?
I like being called hon. Thank you for existing. I'm looking for a tube.
I'm looking for a tube. For a friend, not me.
We have lots of tubes here. Over 3,000 different makes and models. Do you know the two-letter model identifier?
Shit. I think it was WC?
And what is the make number?
67?
Oh, did one of the Hydrantron tubes
run out
again?
Holy shit, I remembered!
Yes. The Pigeon Sisters need one right away.
Okay, I'll put it on the town's account. I'll get one for you, hun. You just wait right there. I'll be back before you know it.
I never remember.
Here you go. Give the pigeons my regards.
Of course, hun. Have a great day. What a lovely person you are. Phone. Oh my. That's a lot of people. I can call these people? Oh, I think I understand what's happening here. These are Kickstarter backers, aren't they? That's a very ingenious way of doing that. Well done. Truly. Parker. Yes.
The doors are locked, and nobody's inside.
Fuck! Feds. Yo, are you a lady of the night?
Excuse me, ma'am.
I'm afraid I don't have any spare change, miss.
I'm a federal agent. Show some respect, or I'll have you booked for solicitation.
Sweetie, I'm not a hooker.
I'm Lenore Edmund Mulch, of the famed Pillowtronics Edmund family, and I'm waiting for my husband and son to arrive on the bus. So I suggest you treat me with a little more respect.
I am so sorry. Alright, I'm gonna be honest, I just slipped away for like 5 minutes because I thought my dog was outside barking, but it turns out it was just the game's ambience. Holy crap. Explain yourself.
So if you aren't turning tricks, what are you doing dressed like that?
If you must know, I'm waiting for my husband and son to arrive so we can go to the will reading. And FYI, grief is no excuse to look like garbage.
Then what's your excuse?
Oh, shit!
Tell me about Pillowtronics.
Pillowtronics was the brainchild of my uncle, the great entrepreneur and genius inventor, Chuck Edmund. The Edmunds made this town great when we opened the Pillow Factory. My family, even my stupid little sister Dolores, might as well be royalty as far as Thimbleweed Park is concerned, sweetie.
You are so right. Tell me about Chuck.
Tell me more about Chuck.
Uncle Chuck was powerful, rich, and surrounded himself with beautiful things. He's everything I aspire to be, sweetie. Without his inventions and money, we'd still be chicken farmers instead of society's elite.
You sound really cool.
You want to be like your uncle?
Yes, yes, yes. I even named my son Chucky after his great uncle. So deep was our connection. I'm sure that will be reflected in the will. Things will change around here when I take control of the Edmund family fortune.
Oh, so you're a bitch.
Do you know anything about the body by the river?
Oh, sweetie. Yes, yes, yes. So glad someone is finally getting rid of it. But one does hear things, and I do have an inkling of who might be connected to this nasty business.
But who?
Tell me who you think is connected to the body.
Well, I hate to cast aspersions, but I suppose it is for the good of the town.
Tell me what you know.
Actually, no, I can't do this. The Edmund reputation is at stake.
But please.
Spill the beans, trust fund Barbie.
Fine, it was my sister Dolores. She abandoned our family and the business to become a...
A pirate?
Pirate.
No, 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 no. It was far worse. She became... A video game developer.
No!
It all started a few years back. She only wanted one thing. To be a game designer for that awful game company. Mucus phlegm.
Ew.
Uncle Chuck wanted something else for her, but no. She was too selfish. Only wanted to make stupid adventure games.
I've got to get out of this town. Uncle Chuck wants me to program his factory computers, but I just want to design games. I wish I could get a job at a company like Mucus Phlegm Games. Now the only thing I have to look forward to is my favorite computer magazine. In fact, I should check the mailbox and see if it's arrived yet.
You should! Also, what? You have a pie?
Ricky Lee's famous Thimbleberry Pie. Hot from the oven.
Hot dog.
Pie. Whoever invented the pie? Here was a great person.
I would eat it. Well, that's a lovely thing. Find the ideal job, check the mailbox, and escape. I like this picture, by the way. It's very well done.
Albert's my hero.
Same.
You're a rebel, Billy.
Billy.
I think Revenge of the Jedi was a much better name.
You're right.
Max was the world's first computer-generated TV host. Someday we'll have one for real.
Never.
It's Uncle Chuck's new invention, the Printron 3000. It's connected to my computer.
Does it type for you? Ooh.
It's graphic basic software from Hessware to supercharge my Commodore 64. It says it's by Ron Gilbert and Tom McFarlane. Wonder who they are. If it weren't for my monthly computer magazine, being here would totally suck.
Dude, these references are insane.
It's Lurline, my pet chinchilla stuffy. Dad gave it to me when I was 3 years old.
I want it.
It's my state-of-the-art Commodore 64, with dual 1541 floppy drives and a blazingly fast 1200 baud modem.
We gotta go.
It's the math trophy I won when I was 12 and attending a summer program at Thomas Bodeman's School of Mathematics. It's made out of solid pewter, except for the infinity symbol, which is pure titanium.
Damn.
It's a red gel decoder.
Y'all want it? Sick.
These are part of my action figure collection, including my prized Howard the Duck.
Dog, you got a Howard the Duck? Sick. You're my new favorite character. Well done.
If it weren't for my monthly computer magazine, being here would totally suck. Just down the hall is the big staircase.
You wanna go? Okay. Good. There's a door here. Hi, door. You wanna go in it? Can you open it? Ah. Ooh.
This is Uncle Chuck's Indextron 3000 library filing lookup system. It uses the Spewy decimal system to catalog books.
Yeah, fuck the Dewey, though.
I should check the mailbox for my computer magazine.
You're right, I'm sorry. I'm going to assume the mail is down here towards where the door is, right? I mean, it only makes sense. This is a fireplace. You don't want to go there. You want to go over here, maybe. Possibly. Hey. Mailbox. Lion.
Hi there, George. I was just about to check the mail. Great timing.
You still around, Dolores? Thought you'd have left this podunk of a town by now.
Yes, hopefully soon. I'm looking for a job at a game company in the big city.
That's not gonna make your Uncle Chuck happy.
He'll just have to deal with it. What brings you all the way out here?
I have your special magazine here.
Oh, I've been waiting for that. Thank you.
Sure, it's what we dedicated government employees do. Walk all the way out into the country to deliver a magazine.
What a nice guy.
It's Bite Me World, the best computer magazine ever.
This looks so nice. Wow. Do you have what it takes to become a highly paid game programmer? Yes, I do. Just complete the Oh shit. I have goals. Non-diet soda and pizza? Sick!
Wow! An ad for a job at Mucus Phlegm Games, my favorite game company. I hear they make movies, too. This could be a dream come true. I'm going to apply. Interesting. There's a modem number to call.
Yep.
Digging?
Doug?
Digging.
Hi, Doug. What are you digging?
All right, Dolores. I'm just digging stuff in the front green. Mostly holes. But then I buries them again, all neat and tidy.
Okay, Doug. You're doing a good job.
Ta, Dolores. Digging in the front green.
God, I love Doug. I'm really glad he works here. Have a good day, Doug. One of the best people in the world. Alright, so there's a modem number to call. So should I go back to my computer door? Also, yeah. Okay. Can do. Here, right? What? Oh! You good? Okay.
Where am I?
I don't know. Okay, we're Scooby-Doo. Chickens. How about the middle door? Yeah, go. Okay. How about this door? Fuck. Alright, this way. Over here, and then this way. I'm sorry, my bad. This door. Wow. What a great house. Okay, modem number to call. All right, what was the modem number? It was... Am I blind? Let's just assume.
Wow! An ad for a job at Mucus Phlegm Games, my favorite game. I'm dialing the Mucus Phlegm modem number. It's connecting. I can't believe my computer's connected to Mucus Phlegm.
Welcome to the new online Mucus Phlegm job application program. Just fill out your personal information and answer a few simple mucus programming questions. Then print out the application and send it to Mucus Phlegm. We'll get back to you in exactly 5 days. What is your name?
Dolores.
Thank you. What is your address?
The all capital letter variant.
Noted. Next, what's your programming language of choice? The language you are most proficient in.
You know what? I have a feeling she's pretty bombastic. All the above.
Very ambitious. We like that. Please answer the following questions about our proprietary mucus programming language. You must get all of the questions right to submit your application.
Fuck.
Okay, first question. This is an easy one. Next question. Also an easy one. Reference counted. A little harder. Ah, debugging is on a second monitor. Last question. Ouch, this is going to take some thinking. Got it! Exclusive ore!
Thank you for taking the Mucus Phlegm programming test. Congratulations, you passed the Mucus Phlegm programming test.
Yay! I answered all the mucus questions correctly. I'm ready to print out the application.
That is a beautiful print. I will be taking that, please. Alright. Somebody's at the door. I'll be back. Have a good day. Door?
That sounds like the doorbell.
You're damn right. Who is at the door?
Hi again, George.
It's not like a government employee to make a mistake, but I forgot to deliver this important letter for your Uncle Chuck.
He's busy in his workshop and can't be disturbed. I'll take it for him.
Okay, Dolores. Here it is. And remember, it's illegal to open someone else's mail. Punishable by a $50,000 fine and or 5 years in jail.
Thanks, George. That's good to know.
Okay, back to my vitally important government job.
Right.
It's a letter to my Uncle Chuck.
Right, which is we should not open it.
I'd better not open it. Uncle Chuck would know if I read it, if the envelope is ripped.
You're right. Okay. Yo, how's the digging going, dude?
Hi, Doug. What are you digging?
All right, Dolores. I'm just digging stuff in the
front. I'd talk to you about
this.
He's tiny like a gnome. All right. I guess...
Digging!
Give this to the mailbox. Okay. Wait, blank paper. What? Blank paper?
Digging!
I printed my job application, but the page is blank.
Frick!
Maybe the printer is out of ink.
Wait.
Digging in the front green!
It's a red gel decoder.
I'm curious. Alright, I don't think it's gonna work, but...
I don't want to do that. It would make it look red.
Okay, I was just curious. Alright,
digging in the front
green Doug.
With my rusty shovel!
You got that that looks fine. The shovel doesn't look rusty to me, but I get it. Alright, where's Uncle? Uncle Chuck. Are you by chance somehow in this?
I can't open that.
I'm gonna push it.
I can't push that.
Gonna pull it. Gonna pull it.
I can't pull that.
Gonna use it. With, pie.
I don't know how to use the fireplace with that.
You're right. Same. This place looks great. Open this. Ooh, ketchup poopsie, perfect. Pick it up. Nice. Are those batteries? Wanna take them as well? We're just taking everything. There's some ketchup. I guess ketchup could be used as ink, right?
Carefully handling broken glass.
Very careful.
If this were a Sierra Online graphic adventure, I'd be dead now.
But those Mucus Phlegm adventure games treat their players much better. No arbitrary deaths just to extend gameplay. Sure would like to work there.
You are stroking your own dick so fierce.
There's nothing inside. There's nothing inside. There's nothing inside.
Is there? How about over here?
There's nothing inside. There's nothing inside. There's nothing inside. There's nothing inside. There's nothing. There's nothing inside. There's nothing inside.
There's a thing inside here, though. There's a thing right there. Pick up. Can I? Okay. Use this.
I think I'll just be careful with them. That's good enough for now. Take that, Sierra Online.
Yes, Sierra Online.
I don't feel like the taste for non-trademark infringing poopsie now.
Same. Okay. Well, Uncle, are you by chance over here?
Franklin, you idiot!
Oh.
I'm just trying to, you know, help.
Is that yelling? Oh, gag me. I hope my dad and Uncle Chuck aren't fighting again.
And since most of the machinery at the pillow factory is lying fallow, I've come up with this, you know, great plan to repurpose them. We can use them to make, you know, plush toys.
Franklin, you idiot! The company is Pillowtronics, not stupid plush toytronics. We make pillows! What do you think that would do to our credibility, our reputation?
Okay, Chuck, you're right, but, I was up all night working on the business plan. Maybe, you could just, you know, look at it?
No, no, no! It's a pillow factory!
Are you two fighting again? I'm getting so sick of this! You're brothers! Take a chill pill! You started the pillow factory together! Won't you ever stop fighting about it?
Nothing you need to worry about, Dolores. Right, Franklin, old brother?
Ah, yes, you know, your uncle and I were just, you know, talking business. I have some work to do.
Dolores, can you get my 0.8mm point-tip soldering iron?
You know, Uncle Chuck, you should use a 2mm flat tip, and you never heat your solder hot enough.
That's my favorite niece. I can't wait for you to take over the pillow factory. I know you'll keep the Edmund pillow dream alive.
Well, about that, my man. What the hell is this?
It's a whip made out of network cables. The label says it's called Cat 509 Tails, produced by getdigital.eu. I guess Uncle Chuck was an impatient system admin back in the day.
Indeed. So you have some mail, my man.
Uncle Chuck, I have something for you.
What is it, Dolores?
A letter George the Postman just delivered.
Oh, I've been expecting this. I'll deal with it later.
Is that ink? Yo, can I have this? I'm just gonna go and take it if that's okay with you. Don't mind me. I love you. Okay, I appreciate you not getting mad about that. You have a robot head?
He's a work of art. I'm looking forward to playing chess with him.
Can I talk to it? Aww.
Uncle Chuck never makes his bed.
Me either.
Hello, my favorite niece.
Hi, Uncle Chuck. I'm actually curious, do you have any of that?
Uncle Chuck, do you have any new printer ribbons?
You know I don't buy new ribbons, I just re-ink them myself. Printer ink is a scam. I didn't get rich by wasting money.
Of course. Thanks, Uncle Chuck.
Printer ink is in fact a scam.
Hello, my favorite niece.
I really want to get a job as a game designer, Uncle Chuck.
I just wanted to say how much I love you, Uncle Chuck.
I love you too, Dolores. I can't wait for you to take over the pillow factory and restore the family heritage.
I can't tell you how I truly feel.
Hello, my favorite niece.
You should be nicer to my father. He just wants to help.
Franklin is well-meaning, I will give you that. But he just doesn't have the same passion and vision for pillows that you and I have.
Fucking pillows.
I just wanted to say how much I love you, Uncle Chuck.
I love you too, Dolores. I can't wait for you to take over the pillow factory and restore the family heritage.
Well, I'ma get going, but thanks for being around. Take it easy. Hey, buddy, I have this for you if you want to use it.
That should do it. The ribbon is now fully inked.
Okay.
It's my state-of-the-art Commodore 60. Yay! I answered all the mucus questions correctly. I'm ready to print out the application. Oh, there's no paper in the Printron 3000.
Oh, would you like this? Shoot. Use it.
There! The blank paper is back in the Printron 3000. Yay! I answered all the mucus questions correctly. I'm ready to print out the application. I always like to watch this part.
That's super neat, actually. Pick up you. Alright, I'm gonna go put this in the mail then. Thank you, Printron. 3000 trademark. Use this and you.
Diggin'!
How exciting. I hope I get the job.
Same. You're still digging.
Hiya, Dolores. I have a letter for you.
Oh!
Good luck. See ya.
Diggin'? Diggin'.
Keep digging, buddy.
It's a letter from Mucus Phlegm. Did I get the job?
I hope so.
I think I want to open this in my room, just in case it's really bad news.
That's true. I don't want to cry in front of Doug. He's a great guy. Alrighty. 5 days later, I haven't gone to the bathroom or eaten in 5 days. I'm very dehydrated. I'm emancipated. I could definitely use some sustenance, but this is important to me.
Now that I'm in my room, I'm still so scared to open it. I need to get up my nerve. Come on, Dolores. You can do it.
I believe in you. Go ahead and drink this.
I don't feel like the taste for non-trademark infringing poopsie now.
The pie.
I don't have time to eat pie right now, even though it looks great.
Get your nerve up. How do we do that? You want to try it again?
Okay, but if it's a no, that means I'm stuck in Thimbleweed Park and have to take over the pillow factory.
Alright, you know what? Go play on your computer.
I'm done with the computer for now.
Okay, you're giving me some guff here, Dolores. You can do this. I believe in you.
Okay, but if it's a yes, what will become of Dad? Stuck here alone with Uncle Chuck.
Just don't think about it.
Okay, but... Okay, I'm opening.
Thank you.
Yes!
Yes!
It's a job offer from Mucus Phlegm to be a game programmer. I'm so excited! Can't wait to tell Uncle Chuck. He'll be so proud. But first...
Yeah! Dancing. I'm dancing. You're such a good dancer. I'm so happy. This is wholly unnecessary. We gotta go. Okay. Thank you for the jig. Alrighty, Uncle. I'm sorry, you might get a little bit upset about this, but you need to understand. I'm following my dream like you followed yours, Uncle. I love you, truly, but you need to know.
Uncle Chuck, great news!
Yes, Dolores, what is it, my dear future leader of Pillowtronics?
Here, read this.
You're what? You're giving up the opportunity to run Pillowtronics to be a game programmer?
Yes, that's what I've always wanted to do. Not run Pillowtronics. I'm leaving on the first bus out of Thimbleweed Park.
Then, Dolores, you are out of my will. You're giving up over $10 million. That's $20 million in 2017 dollars. Just to pick an arbitrary date in the future. You are dead to me.
No. Dolores broke Uncle Chuck's heart and started programming those murder simulators.
Real-life murder is the next logical step for her, sweetie.
Stop her before she schemes her way into sweet Uncle Chuck's inheritance.
Sure, we'll get right on that.
I'm sure you have cats to feed, sweetie.
Ciao.
I can't believe Dolores would do this. She just wanted to program games! Alright, well, listen. I think that was a pretty good idea of what this game is about. And I hope you get the idea by now, if this is something that you'd be down to play yourself.
It's currently on GOG for $20?
And, yeah. It's pretty nice. I actually really like the writing. The voice acting is very solid. There's a lot of, like, small things you can do that I don't really notice. Like, I personally thought vomiting with a hot dog was good, because I've never vomited from a hot dog. I've only had good hot dogs. So it was a new experience for me. That was... Why is that the pinnacle of this experience? I don't know. But I thought that was really neat. And if you like classic adventure games, this is probably up your alley. Maybe. I don't know. If not, then... But yeah. Not bad. Not bad at all. So, I guess that'll be it for me, then. Thank you all for joining me for that. And I guess I'll catch you guys another time. Later, guys. Shoo!